Well, if you have been down to the San Diego Air and Space Museum, chances are very good, if you took a guided tour, that you were toured around that great facility by Mark Carlson and his buddy Musket. What a team they are. I know Mark is an author. One of his passions is aviation, and he writes about aviation. But he and Musket have written a new book. How are you, Mark?
I'm doing great. Glad to be here.
And this book doesn't really center on aviation, does it?
It's just one chapter, but no.
It's called Confessions of a Guide Dog. I've got a copy right back here. And this book has given a great voice to Musket and your experiences together, which covers such a broad range. Now, you've met everybody from Medal of Honor recipients to astronauts, toured them around the Air and Space Museum. Does any one individual stick out as, in your mind, as being an exceptional experience?
Well, it depends on whether you ask me or Musket.
Ah.
He likes anybody
who gives
him treats.
Anybody that gives him treats.
Neil Armstrong and Gene Cernan, John Finn, who is the oldest living Medal of Honor recipient,
right.
Good friends of myself and Musket. We have met some incredible people. We've met Bonnie Hunt and many politicians and so on. It's just, well, he wants to take a nap.
He's going to take a nap. Well, he can't take too much of a nap here because I want to talk to Musket here for a second. Do you mind if I just talk to Musket for a second?
Oh, please do.
Because I'd like to actually, now Musket, you just stay right there. We've got you mic'd up. Musket, how did you get started as a service dog?
Sorry, Mark, I'm a bit sleepy. But to answer your question, I graduated from Guide Dogs for the Blind School in San Rafael. That's where I met my forever human.
So you're talking about Mark then?
Oh, of course. I love him.
Now, I've got to believe that there's some benefits to being a working dog. I mean, to being a guide dog.
Oh, it's incredible. You bet. I can go everywhere, meet lots of wonderful people, and they even give me treats sometimes. In fact, I'm kind of hungry right now. What's that delicious smell?
That's Brant beef. Yeah, that was the Farmer's Market Report. The chef just did that a minute ago.
Sounds great.
I'm sure he's got some treats for you. Mm. I know you've met some interesting people. Try to stay awake for this.
Oh, I'm here, sorry.
Okay, who's most remarkable in your mind?
Oh, the most interesting people I've met, you know, when my daddy and I are on tour guides for the Air and Space Museum, I've been petted by men who have, you know, walked on the moon, even Neil Armstrong.
Whew. So that that was impressive to you, huh?
Oh, it was amazing.
You want to focus on the treats, don't you? Well, let's get this out of the way. What's your favorite treat?
My favorite treat?
Yeah.
All of them. But I do like the ones Daddy is hiding in his pocket.
Wait a second, Mark. Are you hiding
those
treats in your pocket now?
Give them up. I smell them.
Yes, I am. And that's probably what he's waiting for.
I would love a treat.
We got some pictures of you here as a space dog there,
look
Musket.
Look at that. That's when I get treats. You give me treats, that's when I get the smiles out.
So who is the most important person in your life then, huh?
Oh, there we go, buddy. I'm sorry, Mark. What was that? Sorry, there's a treat here.
Who's the most important person in your life?
Of course, the man before me in the blue shirt, my daddy. Thank you, sir. But I do love my mommy the most. She's a sweetheart.
Okay.
Ooh, that tastes so good.
Whoever gives me treats. Oh, my goodness. Why did you guys decide to write the book together?
Well, you know, having a guide dog is rather a unique experience in any case. And he has made so many incredible things happen that they could never have happened without
him. A babe magnet, isn't he?
He is.
Yeah.
Yeah, he definitely. He attracts women like Hugh Jackman in a thong. And the thing about it is that I was so amazed at the things that were happening that, as far as I'm concerned, that if I had to go blind to have such a wonderful experience of having such a great dog in my life, it was worth it.
See, now that's a perspective that I think is probably pretty unique. Mm-hmm. But an interesting one. How long have you been without sight?
Oh, a little over 10 years.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you weren't born blind. So did it happen gradually?
It's hereditary. It's called retinitic pigmentosa. It's a degenerative disorder. It's hereditary. But my father and older brother had it, and it was such a great idea that they decided to pass it on to me. And so I knew it was coming, but I started out with using a cane, and I wasn't that confident with the cane. And time went on, my cousin kept pressing me to get a guide dog, my brother was pressing me to get a guide dog, and I finally decided to do it. And I could not have picked a better match. I mean, he has just been an incredible influence. I used to be a Civil War reenactor here in San Diego, and when they told me I was getting a guide dog named Musket, I knew it was you know, somebody was looking out. Yes, it was definitely.
It was fate.
He has just changed my life and so many people's lives and made so many people happy. That's why I decided to write the book.
So, Musket, I got to ask you, why in the world did you decide, you know, that you even needed Mark to write this book?
Well, it's an amazing story. I think it's fantastic. I love being with him, and I love helping him.
Mark tells it, he's the only one that could type.
I'm the subwriter, the ghostwriter, if you will. We bounce off ideas each other all day long. It's great.
You're the spell checker, he says.
Spell checker. Can I get some more treats?
We'll see what we can do. Hey, Mark, the book is absolutely fascinating, and it is a who's who, especially of folks in your life, but folks down at the Air and Space Museum. Can folks come down and see you?
They certainly can.
And I know that you're going to be at the Rancho Bernardo Winery as well Saturday, and folks can come out and... this is going to be
February 11th.
February 11th. Okay.
Yeah, Saturday, February 11th.
Saturday, February. So folks can plan ahead at Cafe Merlot, Rancho Bernardo Winery. Plan on being there, but you're still doing tours at the Air and Space Museum?
Yes, I do. And I really enjoy it. It's always a unique experience.
So folks, come down and request Mark and Musket. All right? And if folks are going to bring a treat for Musket, what do they bring?
It's something healthy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Definitely
that's what
healthy.
I'm thinking. Something healthy, a lean treat.
Yeah.
All right. Mark, wonderful to have you here once again. Thank you so much.
Thank
Confessions
you very
of a
much
Guide
for having
Dog. Pick up a copy of this thing and really enjoy it. And again, you're a local treasure, and Musket, so are you.
Thank you very much.
All right. More treats, he says. All right. Up next, celebrating the whales. A little preview of the festival dedicated to these incredible ocean animals happening right here in San Diego. Look at that.